What are you looking at? But anyway, hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. Now you're gonna look to the side, are you? Okay. But anyway, in this part, we will be entering this temple-like area. But to enter here, we have to actually shoot eggs into the little dragon head. So we'll be doing that right here. There's 1, 2, 3, 4 little dragon heads, 5 little dragon heads, and 6 little dragon heads. And that's how you count. Welcome to Counting with Yankee. Okay. Alright, now we can enter inside, and let's see, what's in this ancient little thing? Or big thing, I should say. It's huge. Look at all this gold. Treasure chamber. Awesome. What's up with you? It's terrible. I can't find Target Zan's favorite priceless relic thingy. I think it may have been stolen. Tough luck. We don't care. Help Chief Belota Zin find it, and I'll reward you with the Jiggy. A Jiggy? Well, in that case... Banjo saw dollar signs. Great, I'll open the other door for you. But please hurry! Looks like he's gonna open the top door, and looks like you can only access that area by flying, so we'll have to make our way to the fly pad stat. Yeah, this guy's basically, it's his first day on the job, and he lost the only thing he had to guard. And I love how he's scrambling to find this ancient relic thing when he's surrounded by gold. Dude, be grateful. Have some humility, man. I'd take all that gold for that relic thingy. It's probably not even a nice relic thingy. It's probably one of those things you can get off like a cruise ship and buy it for like $100 and it'd be like a knockoff or something. It's not like that happened to me before. And it was like a fake Rolex. So it's only $50. It stopped working, but I fixed it. Okay, stop. Let's see. Let's go to the world entry and go to that fly pad. And make our way to that entrance where the Cheeto Pad is. Cheeto Pages. I combine Cheeto Pad. Cheeto Page and Cheeto. God, I can't talk. I combine the Cheeto Page and the Fly Pad. So let's just make our way here. Just get a whole scope of the area. Like, look at this. It's a really small area when you come down to it, but there's a lot of stuff to do inside. So, oh, I was gonna try flying again, but. Oh well, nothing on top. So let's just fly down. Oh, whoops, I flew directly into it. Okay, let me try to get out again. Luckily, that's there. In case you mess up like I did. So let's get that Cheeto Page. I think that's 2 out of 3 here. And now we're still in the treasure chamber. We have to fix the camera angle right here. It's not cooperating. There we go. And we go down here. I think I pretty much bypassed what you were supposed to do because I see there's like a grip pad right here. Or a grip area type thing. And but that's actually get an empty honeycomb. So we'll be doing that at the end, obviously. So, okay, I didn't bypass anything. Alright, so without further ado, we are guarded by this gate. But if you step on the switch, the gate disappears. I tried ground pounding it my first time around, but nope, you just gotta step on it. Ah, the easy things in life. But yes, this is Unga Bunga's cave. Real original caveman name, but... Oh yeah, and I actually did some research. If you can bypass doing... This is a stealth section, by the way, just like the snake. But I found out you can jump into the fire and bypass the whole security thing. So if anyone could do that, by all means, send a video response. But that's real, like I can see from right there, if you jump in the non-bushed area onto the fire over it, that's pretty risky. But I'm just gonna gotta take this slow. You gotta get like a little start. No, that's not good enough. Not going. Okay, good, perfect. Alright, we gotta take this nice and slow. Yeah, I would recommend just getting basically like a 5-inch, staying 5 inches behind or like a foot behind the red vines right here, so you just get a little slow walking start. Usually the saying is running start, but we just gotta get right past this cave. Kinda weird to see a caveman in this kind of world, but it is the Mayans, but cavemen didn't exist in the Mayan era. They are much more civilized, but we have this ancient relic thingy. What is, I don't know, looks pretty valuable. It's made up of gold, probably, so maybe it is worth all those gold piles that guy was stressing over. Maybe I just want to take it myself. How much you asking for, Bloatsan? I love how all, like, the characters in this game are basically puns based on the worlds they're in. Like, everything ends with Zin in this world, and, like, the ancient god is Target Zin, and this fat guy's name is, like, Bloatsan. And we'll be seeing why they're called Target Zin shortly, because that's the last area we'll be going into. That was that big temple that I've been putting off until this part. And, I don't know, for some reason we had to carry it in here, but now we don't have to carry it. I guess we snuck it away in our pocket. Or our backpack. I'm sorry about that, Kazooie. So let's just jump over here and go. Oh, God! That wasn't obvious. Like, usually they have those yellow pads, but I guess if you zoom out. There you go. Okay, there you go. Tips for anyone playing. Zoom out. And you'll be able to see everything. everything. Okay, maybe some things you don't want to see. And bees to let go, and let's see, we don't need that shock pad, we just gotta fly right here, okay. And there we go. And if you fell right there, that would have been tough luck right there. There we go, that's 3 empty honeycomb pieces, awesome. And there we go, we found your little shiny relic thing. You found Target Sand's priceless relic thingy. I even called it that. The caveman stole it. Why, those thieving little... Careful, this is a family game. Oh yes, so it is. Why don't you? I just give you a Jiggy? That makes sense to me. Oh god, if you thought that, like, the dialogue in this area alone is amazing, but... Oh god, just so awesome. Oh, Unga Bunga! I pebble god me in much trouble, big beatings! Oh, look at him flail his arms in the air. Show me like he just don't care. Say oh! Oh! Okay, that's probably bad. That's exactly like the oh he said. Aw, poor Unga Bunga. I'm putting down cavemen since 2013. There's the Jiggy. Placed in the corner. I don't know why he just didn't hand it to me, but the transfer was complete. We have a Jiggy. That's all that matters, right? Alright, so that took up enough time. So let's go into the temple right here. I believe that was our 6th Jiggy. We need two's in here. Actually, wait. Before we go in the temple, there's one more I didn't get. Oops. Oopsie doodle. And it's actually a really easy one, so it'll probably take like not even a minute. Oh, come on. If you're on the edge, you basically have to go right in the smack dab middle. Prison near ones. I think it's by the wigwam. Come on, please be by the wigwam. I think it is. Did I mess up? Yeah, I messed up, oh well. And we already got that Cheeto page. Whoops! I always fail at these 50-50 chance kind of things. I don't know. Wish it was more 100 chance kind of thing, you know what I'm saying? We have to go to the prison compound, that's it. Yeah, because we never went to the prison compound as Banjo and Kazooie. So that kind of makes sense. And over here is actually, we're gonna get to the area that we can't get the Jiggy in yet, so I'll show that off. But for now, we're gonna go left, not right, and get this pretty easy Jiggy. It's probably the easiest one to grab in the game. The reason I said grab is you need to know the grip grab to get to it, to get to the waiting boots, to cross this little muck right here. So yeah, this muck can be crossed by that giant starry thing. Oh god, what was that? What the hell? It looked like an alien. That was kind of random. That was like a big lipped alligator moment. But yeah, let's get off the boots by hitting X, and there we go, the 9th Jiggy, awesome, okay. Really moving along in this game, and there we go, let's get the waiting boots back. So that only took like a minute or so to get. Really just a handout Jiggy. Really wish all of them were like that, but no, in this game, the Jiggies are way more challenging, and you'll have to take much more time and like effort and strategy in getting them. And like I said before, the worlds in this game are going to be at least half hours each, so... Unlike the last game, you can't just breeze right through it. And let's go outside the Mumbo Skull, because we are ready to enter Target Zan's Temple. And the thing about the Briegel Buster move that we learned in, like, 2 parts ago, I didn't put this 2 and 2 together and never entered this temple. I never actually did these 2 Jiggies, like, when I first played this game, when I first got it. And I was like, what is that move? What is that move? How do I access Kazooie as a gun? That's awesome. But no, this move is only usable in certain areas. Like this one. Good, I see you have mastered the art of bird handling. I now challenge you to collect the sacred statues and find your prize. Alright, Olmec, I guess this really is Legends of the Hidden Temple. Aw, oh, man, I just love how you said, like, I love how you learned to handle your bird. Who would have thought to make it, like, to a shotgun? You're a genius, you're a maverick, you're a MacGyver. Alright, so there's 25 of these little blue statues that we have to collect. We need to collect them all to get all 2 Jiggies that are in this temple. So, I'm pretty much just gonna freestyle here. I'm really not going off a strategy or anything. Even though I have a strategy guide right next to me. It's actually Nintendo's Banjo-Tooie strategy guide. I had a Prima Banjo-Kazooie one, but that one was just awful. I'm so happy my parents got the Nintendo one this time around. Much more, informative, and okay, we can get easy 5 right here, but this is hard. Basically, just gotta charge it. Ugh. But void, I know I can just hit him out, but it's hard. It's hard. Just wear it. Wear the damage. Okay, good. Not bad, mortal. 10 statues gains you entry to my slightly sacred chamber. See, all he needs 10 to get to one of the Jiggies, but you need, I think, 20 or 25. I think you just need 20, I'm not sure. don't get those golden eggs yet. As you can see, those eggs are a different color. You'll be wanting to get that later on, so I'm going to avoid that for now. Just a pro tip. And this, the first person section thing, I don't know. It's kind of nice in this temple, in this area, but in the next world, I absolutely hate this section. I'm going to spoil right now. There is another one of these sections in the next world. It is my least favorite Jiggy to get, based on a mechanic I always hate in games. But I won't be spoiling it, so you will eventually see me suffering in that. That'll definitely be a fail montage, I'm telling you right now. It's that's probably my hardest Jiggy I ever have to get in the game, so. And it's funny that it comes in, like, World 2. Let's see, I'm really losing track of where I am. There's a door right here. Can we open it? Okay, good. That opens up to a new area. Awesome. Oh, God. Yeah, these guys are just more of a nuisance rather than them actually trying to kill me. Just flail around. But yeah, I think you only need 20, and they give you 25, so this is really just a cakewalk. And really, no stakes are at hand. It's not like it's a time section or anything. Alright, so let's see. Have I been here before? I don't know. I haven't. Okay, I did. Let's see. Any more? Just one, really? Okay, that's weird. Oh, God. And yeah, you basically have to always, like, check your corners here. They always just pop out of nowhere, and they regenerate pretty fast, so... Yeah, okay, I was just here. Whoops. I'm losing my bearings! So let's sing the Losing Your Bearings song. No, we're not gonna do that. Let's see, where are we? Okay, that was that. I didn't want to get to that. Let's go up, actually. Have we been in this blue area? I don't think we have, because there's actually something we need to grab before we leave here. Oh, I have it, okay. I didn't think I would get lost as easily. I'm sorry about that. So let's open. Oh, we're back to start, really? Okay. Let's go back in. I really wanted to make this part nice and, like, I knew this was going to be a long part because I'm going to collect all the Jiggies in this part, but I may just cut away if I'm taking a little bit too long, but for now, I think I'll just hang on to the commentary. Okay, we're back to this part. Okay, I'm really going in circles right now. There's only two left, too. I can look at my guy. It tells me where every single one is, but it's really kind of useless if I've not taken track of what I've collected so far. Let's see here. Okay, there we go. Two of them, awesome, I think that's it. Oh, wow, they're at the where I had to go, okay. I wasn't expecting that. There we go, gained sentry to the really secret chamber. Okay, wow, okay, I psyched myself out. I got them all relatively early, but I forgot the last two were actually by the, entrances to the chambers. Whoops. Alright, so we just want to go in here to get the, Jinjo. And whoa, that's really up close and personal, isn't it? That's two red Jinjos. We collected already two red ones early in the game, and we have to go back to the golden egg area, which is over here. And I'll just explain to you why I saved it till last. Kill you. And there we go. Basically, we have 60 seconds, unlimited fire, no repercussions. So you definitely want to have this during the boss fight, because it'll make it just that much easier. So there we go, and this is going to gain us entry into the slightly sacred chamber, I believe. Yeah, slightly sacred chamber. There we go, free Jiggy, okay. Alright, so I hope the next chamber is just like that, man. That was for collecting 10 of those little blue statue things. Let's see what happens if you collect 20. Is it going to be like a birthday cake or anything? I'm all up for surprises. Alright, so this is it. Target Zan's really sacred chamber. Look, Banjo, there's another Jiggy. This is just too easy. Yep, we'll have the game finished in no time. Another fourth wall breaking, and oh god, that wall's not breaking anytime soon, and that thing hopefully will be. Halt, mortal! Thought you'd get another Jiggy that easily, eh? Whoa, Target Zan, despotic, dizzy, totem god! Yes, he is the boss of the Mayhem Temple. I am Target Zan, Matty Mighty Moyen, God of Shooting. Prepare to meet thy dart-ridden doom! Alright, so basically you see a little thing on the bottom right. That is how many hits that'll take to get Target Zan out. But if you have the golden eggs, you can just spray fire everywhere. But to advance to the next stage, I can't feel my legs anymore. Get him, you worthless moogies! These things are called moogies. I don't know why they're cats, I don't know, but... I guess it's kind of original, but instead of just calling attack creatures, but we killed one of them. There we go. Look at that. I just, like, wrecked that. I'm gonna wreck it. Let's see. Come on. I'm running out of time on this. Go. Go, golden eggs. There we go. Just basically just fire around when you have this thing. Like, look at this. Look how easy this boss fight is if you do what I did. My first time around, I actually got the golden eggs without thinking anything of it. And once you get them, you can't get them again, I don't think. So you definitely want to pick your spots and only use it, you know, obviously, in the boss fight. Because walking around with that is kind of stupid. And you got to watch the dart. So basically, when you choose to go left. Okay, I didn't go left there. I didn't pizza. All right, and then there's one more. I'll take that hit. And there we go. Is he done? No, he's not. We got to take down the remaining Moogies. Whoa, Moogie. Easy, Moogie. Is there one more? Yep. And... Oh, no! I'm out of ammo. I gotta find eggs. So there, basically, if I didn't have the golden eggs, did you see how fast you can run out of ammo in the spot? Just by firing randomly? Is that it? Awesome. No! You've beaten me! Now suffer as I invoke my sacred self-destruct! Alright, take cover here. If you're in the fire, you will die, actually. Yes, you will die. That's why you need to take cover, so... That's definitely gonna keep you, catch you off guard, but if you pretty much played this boss before, played this game before, we've got him. We've got him, R2. And that's it. We are done with Target Zan's Temple. I think I did actually pretty good. I did better than I expected, but I don't know. I kind of, looking back, it was kind of silly that I got hung up on that. Those last two golden, or not golden, but those last two blue statues. There's actually 25, so if I struggle to get 20, wow. I didn't think that would be a problem. So let's see. Let's just make our way back outside of the temple and out of this world. Not to the stars, not Mario Galaxy, but yes, because we are done with this world, and we can get some honey right here with this little honey thing. Those things I don't think I've mentioned before, they give you tons of honeycombs if you run out of health. But you really shouldn't. You have like 5 or 6 slots right now. Really hard to die in a Banjo game unless you jump from a high spot. Otherwise, it's fair game for gravity to take over. Alright, so we're out of the temple, and yes, we've only collected 9 Jiggies in this world. Like I said before, we have to re-enter worlds in this game and do a lot of backtracking, so we can't get one Jiggy just yet because we don't know a certain move. And, oh yeah, I think did I show that off? Hold on, let me see. If I showed it off, it'll come up in my totals. I'm not sure if that was in my practice. I didn't. Okay, I remember. Okay. Basically, when I went to go get that Jiggy with the boots, I mentioned you can go right. I didn't go right and show that off. So I'm going to show it off real fast. I'm sorry about that. This part's going to be pretty long, but... Heck, we finished the world, so... Oh, well, what are you going to do? I almost got them all, like, at least 15 each, but I knew this last one was going to be the biggest part, probably, in the whole Banjo-Tooie series so far, and that's not going to help me ending this part off sooner. And I gotta zoom out against these guys. I gotta follow my own advice. Okay, there we go. I think that's the only one. Hey, I caught that one. Cool. Alright, so just once we get over here, we'll get up. And I'll show off the area that we'll be going to next time we come here after the next world. Because in the next world, the new move's available. And there we go. There's a Cheeto page. And we pretty much 100% of the world as of now. And we cannot get that Jiggy because we cannot destroy that boulder just yet. Yes, Banjo does not know the move Rock Smash yet. Okay, that's just, there's not really a move called Rock Smash in this game. That's just Banjo-Tooie. Alright, so let's get out of here. Let's get the heck out of here. I always make fun of that. It's not really a joke. I just always say that in my Let's Plays. Let's get out of here. Stop the car. It's from Pineapple Express when they're like in the car and it's like dead. No, we cannot leave. The car is dead. It ceased to exist. What? Alright, so let's enter the world entry and exit. And let's finally get out of here, shall we? Alright, so that was the first world of the game. Not Mumbo's Bound by any means. It probably took us about 40 minutes, but hey, it was a pretty easy world. It was a nice little tutorial world. I like it. I like it a lot. It's definitely one of my favorites, and it's definitely better than the second world, which we'll be unlocking in the next part. So, next time on Let's Play Banjo-Tooie, we'll be entering Jiggy Wiggy's Temple and unlocking the second world in the game that I'm not looking forward to, but I'm pretty sure it's a favorite among others. So I'll see you later, guys, and until next time. Hey, man, you want to grab some McJiggies? Oh, Kazooie, alright, stop it!